Good morning, students. Today we are going to start unit number 7, Genetics and Evolution. In this chapter, we'll be studying about the work of the Mendel and also others who followed him and gave us an idea of inheritance patterns. In this unit, there are 3 chapters. Chapter number 5, Principles of Inheritance and Variation. Chapter 6, Molecular Basis of Inheritance. And chapter 7, Evolution. First, we will start with chapter number 5, Principles of Inheritance and Variation. In this chapter, we will cover first Mendel's laws of inheritance, inheritance of one gene, inheritance of two genes, sex determination, mutation, genetic disorders. Have you ever wondered why an elephant always give birth to a baby elephant and not some other animal? Or why a mango seed forms only a mango tree and not any other plant? Given that they do, are the offsprings identical to their parents, or do they show differences in some of their characteristics? Have you ever wondered why siblings sometimes look so similar to each other, or sometimes even so different? This is all about to answer that why offsprings are identical or different from their parents, and why the siblings are similar or dissimilar to each other. These answers we can find here in this chapter. These and several related questions are dealt with scientifically in a branch of biology known as genetics. This subject deals with the inheritance as well as the variation of the characters from parents to offsprings. Inheritance is the process by which characters are passed on from parent to progeny. This we have to remember. It is the basis of heredity. Variation is the degree by which a progeny differ from their parents. So these are the two things, inheritance and variation. Inheritance में उन characters की बात की जाती है जो parents से progeny में transfer किए गए हैं, जबकि variation उस degree को कहा जाता है जितनी degree से parents से offspring differ करते हैं. So one is based on similarity and other on the dissimilarity. Humans knew from as early as 8000 to 1000 BC that one of the causes of variation was hidden in sexual reproduction. They exploited the variations that were naturally present in the wild population of plants and animals to selectively breed and select for the organism that possessed desirable characters. For example, through artificial selection and domestication from ancestral wild cows, we have well-known Indian breeds, example Sahiwal cows in Punjab. We must, however, recognize that though our ancestors knew about their inheritance of characters and variation, they had a very little idea about the scientific basis of this phenomena. No doubt they produced the breeds like Sahiwal cows in Punjab, but they didn't did it on the scientific basis. Now the first topic of this chapter is Mendel's law of inheritance. It was during the mid 19th century that headway was made in the understanding of inheritance. Gregor Mendel conducted hybridization experiments on garden peas for 7 years from 1856 to 1863 and proposed the laws of inheritance in living organisms. During Mendel's investigations into inheritance patterns, it was for the first time that statistical analysis and mathematical logic were applied to problems in biology. His experiments had a large sampling size, which gave greater credibility to the data he collected. These are all the characteristic features due to which Mendel got success in his experiments. Also, the confirmation of his inferences from experiments on successive generation of his test plants proved that his results pointed to general rules of inheritance rather than being unsustained ideas. In unique features ki wajah se ye prove ho paya ki Mendel ne jo dhunda hai wo general rules hain inheritance ke na ki sirf ideas. Mendel investigated characters in garden pea plant that were manifested as two opposing traits, example tall or dwarf plants, yellow or green seeds. This allowed him to set up a basic framework of rules governing inheritance, which was expanded later by scientists to account for all the diverse natural observations and complexity inherent in them. Mendel conducted such artificial pollination, cross-pollination experiments using several true breeding pea lines, each pure with the same character. A true breeding line is one that, having undergone continuous self-pollination, shows the stable trait inheritance and expression of several generations. Mendel selected 14 true breeding pea plant varieties as pairs, which were similar except for the one character with the contrasting traits. Some of the contrasting traits selected were smooth or wrinkled seeds, yellow or green seeds, and many more. Let us see here in the chart. Seed shape, round, wrinkled. Seed color, yellow, green. Flower color, violet, white. Pod shape, that is ye cover ka shape iska jo hai, that is full constricted. Full ko kabhi kabhi inflated bhi kaha jata hai. Pod color, green, yellow. Flower position, axial, terminal. Stem height, tall, dwarf. These were the 7 pairs of contrasting traits in the pea plant studied by Mendel. Next topic, let us see inheritance of one gene. Let us take the example of one such hybridization experiment carried out by Mendel, where he crossed tall and dwarf pea plants to study the inheritance of one gene. He collected the seeds produced as a result of this cross and grew them to generate the plants of first hybrid generation. Let us see how he crossed. He selected two plants with contrasting trait, male parent with the white flowers and female parent with the violet flowers. He chose the pollen of the white flowers and pollinated them onto the violet flowers stigma. Then he got the plant seeds and grown them. All of them were violet flowers. In his first experiment, he chose the tall and dwarf pea plants as their parents. He crossed them and got the first generation. This generation is called filial progeny or F1 generation. Mendel observed that all the F1 progeny plants were tall. Like one of its parents, none were dwarf. He made similar observation for the other pair of traits. He found that F1 always resembled either of the one parents and that the trait of other parent was not seen in them. Here in this diagram, it is evident that parental generation tall and dwarf were crossed and all the seeds were sown and got the F1 generation as only tall plants. But when the tall plants were selfed, that is, they were crossed, in the next generation, 3 plants obtained were tall, but dwarf plant was also seen. That is, in the F2 generation, the dwarf plant was seen. Mendel then self-pollinated the tall F1 plants, as I told you. To surprise, he found that in F2 generation, one offspring or some of the offsprings were dwarf. The character that was not seen in F1 is now expressed in F2. The proportion of the plants that were dwarf were very small, but it was seen. It was only 1/4 of the F2 plants, while 3/4 of the F2 plants were tall. The tall and the dwarf traits were identical to their parental type and didn't show any blending. That is all. The offsprings were either tall or dwarf. None were of in-between height. Here we can see 1/4 is dwarf while 3/4 is tall. Similar results were obtained with the other traits that he studied. Only one of the parental traits was expressed in the F1 generation, while in the F2, both the traits were expressed in the proportion of 3:1. 3, the trait of the F1 generation, and 1 of the dwarf parent. The contrasting traits didn't show any blending at either F1 or F2 stages. If we use alphabetical symbols for each gene, then the capital letter is used for the trait expressed at F1 stage and small alphabet for the other trait. For example, in case of this cross, height, T is used for tall and small t for dwarf, and the capital T and small t are considered as alleles of each others. Hence, in plants, the pair of alleles for height would be capital T, capital T, capital T, small t, and small t, small t. Mendel also proposed that in a true breeding line, tall or dwarf P variety, the allelic pair of genes for height are identical or homozygous TT and small tt respectively. Capital T and small tt are called the genotype of the plant. Well, the descriptive terms tall and dwarf are the phenotype. What then would be phenotype of a plant that had a genotype capital T small t? As Mendel found, the phenotype of F1 heterozygote capital T small t to be exactly like the capital T parent in appearance, he proposed that in a pair of dissimilar factors, one dominates the other. For example, here, the capital T dominates over the small t. The factor which is expressed is known as dominant factor, while the other is recessive factor. So here, tallness is the dominant over the dwarfness. He observed the same in other traits also. It is convenient to use the capital and lowercase of the alphabetical symbol to remember this concept of dominance and recessiveness. Do not use T for tall and D for dwarf, because it will be difficult to remember T and D, that both are the traits of the same character. Alleles can be similar as in the case of homozygous, and dissimilar in case of heterozygous. Here only one character for height is used, hence it is a monohybrid cross between capital T capital T and small t small t. From this observation, the recessive parental trait is expressed without any blending in the F2 generation. We can infer that when the tall and dwarf plant produce gametes by the process of meiosis, the alleles of the parent are separated from each other or segregate from each other, and only one allele is transmitted to the gamete. This segregation of alleles transmitted to a gamete is random process, and so there is 50% chance of gamete containing either allele has been verified by the results of crossing. In this way, the gametes of the tall capital T capital T plants have the allele capital T, and the gametes of the dwarf small t plants have the allele small t. During fertilization, the two alleles capital T and small t from the parents through the egg and the pollen unites to produce a zygote that have one capital T and one t small allele. In the other words, the hybrids have capital T and small t. Since these hybrids contain alleles which express contrasting traits, the plants are called heterozygous. The production of gametes by the parents, the formation of zygote, the F1 and F2 plants can be understood from a diagram called Punnett square. See here, this type of a square is formed in which one side gametes of one plant are shown and other side gametes of another plant are shown, and their combinations are written over there in the square. After the selfing, for the F2 generation also we can draw the same Punnett square and we can obtain the two different types of ratio: phenotypic ratio 3:1 and genotypic ratio 1:2:1. It was developed by a British geneticist, Reginald C. Punnett. It is a graphical representation to calculate the probability of all possible genotypes of offspring in a genetic cross. The possible gametes are written on the two sides, usually the top row and the left columns. All possible combinations are represented in the box below in the squares which generate a square output form. The Punnett square shows the parental tall capital T, capital T and dwarf small t plants, the gametes produced by them and the F1 capital T small t progeny. The F1 plants of genotype capital T small t are self-pollinated, and symbols for male and female are used to denote the male plant and the female plant. What other studies of the Punnett square revealed and what the other crosses that Mendel did were all put together, and Mendel derived the laws of inheritance. That we will continue in the next lecture.